Welcome to another edition of Chaplain John with Chaplain John Sayers, featuring special reports and interviews with people doing kingdom ministry in Tulare County and beyond. And now, here's Chaplain John.
Hey, this is Chaplain John, and actually, I'm in Sacramento, California, and it's June 12th. And the reason I'm here, I'm in my hotel room, and my sister Joanne brought me up here, and because you know I don't drive anymore, because our grandniece graduated from high school, and we wanted to come up, and it was great being with the family, and she graduated from the Cornerstone Christian School, and I wanted to share with you a little bit about the Cornerstone Christian School. Let me give you their vision statement. I got the program that they gave to us. Their vision statement is to produce well-rounded, self-governed leaders who apply the Word of God to every area of their life, Mission, to work with like-minded Christian parents, to educate our children with love and mercy in a godly environment that emphasizes a righteous biblical curriculum, Christian character training, and college preparatory academics. I have to tell you, I was so, this graduation service was more like a worship service. This school reminded me a lot of the John Adams Academy. It's not a school, it's not a Christian school, but it's a charter school. I'm very impressed with them, and I'm going to do more work with them. I actually got to interview. You could look at other YouTubes. I actually interviewed some of the high school seniors at the John Adams Academy. Very impressed. These kids gave me hope. These kids at this school gave me hope. I was so impressed. I'm hoping to do more interviewing with these kids. And at the ceremony, it was really awesome. The seniors, and there's seven of them, including my grandniece, they all gave a short 2-minute testimony of what the school meant to them, but really what their relationship with God meant to them. It was rich. It was powerful. I felt like I was in a worship service. I found myself going, amen, amen, amen. There was one girl, and they all gave great examples, but I wanted to share with you one gal who was a senior. She didn't start going to the school until she was a freshman. Some of them started when they were like first grade all the way through. She started when she was a freshman. Up to that time, she said she was a goofball. She was a problem kid. She was very bright, and she just goofed off completely in school. School, I guess, didn't challenge her, so she goofed off. I don't know. But her folks decided to enroll her in the Cornerstone Christian School, and she gave a testimony, and she talked about how she goofed off. But when she came to the school, high academic school, as John Adams Academy, very high academics, and this school was too, she learned the joy of learning. I think the learning challenged her too, and she learned how to learn, and it was a joy. And she said, as she learned, she also learned responsibility. I have never put learning in school and responsibility. She said learning gave her a gift, a stronger learning of responsibility. She became responsible. She said she's going to do some tutoring. By the way, my grandniece is going to do some tutoring too. And you know, and she's going to go on to college. But she goes, I feel like I owe something to this world. I'm responsible to this world. That excites me when I see youth feeling like they are responsible in this world. They're not looking for the world to do something for them. I keep coming back to John Kennedy, his message, his famous lines: don't ask what the country can do for you. Don't ask for handouts. Ask what you can do for the country. these kids that are coming out of John Adams Academy and Cornerstone Christian School, they're being taught that they have a responsibility to the world around them. And man, I saw hope. And I started thinking, you know, the more I learn, the more I grow in my relationship with God, and I'm still growing. I am still growing. The more that learning is going to also help me grow in my being responsible. Until Jesus comes, we Christians are called to be responsible in this world by our love, our actions, by our deeds. We're saved by grace. But if you're saved by grace, we also have a call to be responsible. That's what these kids are giving to me in both schools, Cornerstone Christian School, John Adams Academy. They're giving me hope. Well, that's what I wanted to share with you. I have more coming down the point on the both schools. I hope you catch on. I'm going to interview some more students. They will give you hope, to have hope, to be more responsible. God bless. I wanted to get that out tonight because I'm heading back to Visalia tomorrow, and I'll get this out. Probably I'll get out tomorrow. God bless. Well, let's share hope. Yes, hope. Amen.